iMovie gives you the options of adding themes. These themes can enhance the look of your video. Let's go over here to our media browsers on our toolbar, and let's click on the transition icon, which is the hourglass. Now at the very top of this browser window right here, you're going to see a button that says Set Theme. Go ahead and click on that. This should look a little familiar to you. This option was available to you whenever you first saved or first created the project. And when we first created this project here in this training video, we selected no theme. Now that I'm just about done with my video, I'm changing my mind and I'm thinking maybe that I would like to add a theme to it. So I can access it through going to Transitions and then Set Theme. And then I get this box and I have seven different themes that I can choose from. Newscast and sports themes were added in iMovie 11. So I think I'm going to choose Scrapbook, and I'll go ahead and click OK. And you can see it's going to do some things to my project. First of all, it added a little bit of a theme. It added the theme right here. It added this floral background to the theme. If I want to go in and change the name of this right here, it just took the name of the project and inserted it right there. But if I want to change that, I can. I can just click on this and my viewer becomes a editing window. And I can change this to EIU in summer. There we go, click done. The other thing that it did is it added some customized theme transitions. You'll notice the difference between the icons. This icon right here is just one of the normal transition icons. It's the transition for cross dissolve. And this icon right here that looks like it has a couple pages on it, that's actually a transition that goes along with the different themes. So that's how you'll tell the difference between the two types of transitions in your project. If I click on this, you'll see that this particular theme includes a customized transition that takes different frames from the video and inserts them into this page layout, kind of like a scrapbook. And if you click on this icon, you can actually identify what frames go in these boxes. You'll notice that they're numbered 1, 2, 3, and 4, and then the frames that are represented in each one of those boxes are numbered over here in your project. So like frame 1 is a booth library. If I want to change that, all I have to do is pick up this number and move it around in my project. I can move it down here to the purple flowers. And let's see. Box number 2 shows the map. Let's say I want to pick this one up and put it on the water tower. There we go. And number 3 I'll pick up and put it on the still image that I added right here. And number 4 I'll pick this one up and move it down. And sometimes this can be a little hard to get that to move down. Sometimes you have to do what I call piecemeal, drop it, and go ahead and slide your bar down to get farther down in your project, and pick up the number again, and then slide it down. So maybe I'll show the B as my 4th one. So that's how you can change those. Not every theme has transitions like this that you can control what frames are being shown in the theme transition, but this one did, and this one that I selected was called Scrapbook. Let me click Done, and now the transition that I edited was this one right here. So now let me play that back so you can see the transition. There. So that's how themes work.